Listen, we're already late. Can't you just do one shift without an espresso?
Last time I did that, I tried taking a blood sample from a mattress.
I'm so sorry. I didn't even see you. Oh, I've been brushed off my feet.
It's all right. There's no need for a breakdown. It's just coffee.
Last time I saw you, you were saving my life in the hospital, and this is how I repay you.
Oof. Take that second base. You could buy me a drink first.
Oh, no, I didn't mean... Oh, I should just start today all over again. Let me get you a coffee on the house.
She's too cute. Should we pick her up and take her home with me?
Yeah, and you're probably her type too, so hurry up, get her digits, because we're late.
Here, once you taste my creamy frap, it'll be like that stay never happened.
How about lunch? Bet the dog. I mean, it's least you could do with the over-the-clothes action.
Yeah, of course, I'll see you there.
See that? Free coffee and a date.
Still got it, sis. Hey! Did you get my text?
What happened yesterday?
Sorry, I have been manic here, that's why I didn't call. But it was fine. I can't really talk right now.
What? When? I need to know what they said.
I'll be at the dog at lunch, I'll see you there.
I'm sorry, Rory, I'm late. I was stuck in a meeting.
Oh, it's all right, we've only been here 5 minutes.
We?
If this is a vintage Merlot, then I am Charlize Theron.
Oh, hi.
Billy Frankie drowns her tuna in mayo, so that is out. And why don't we lay off the chips, yeah?
I didn't realise you brought your mum along.
What's your mouth, sweetheart?
You're choosing everything she eats. What's that about?
I'm going to have a jacket spud with beans, if that's all right with you.
OK, so what is this? Open relationship? I mean, I'm up for most things, but you're so possessive. It's going to end in tears.
What?
Well, she should have told me you were with her when I asked her out.
Yeah. Yeah, she should have. One moment. Well, I knew you were naive, but this takes a biscuit. How did you not realise you were on a date?
A date? Don't be daft. I just said I'd buy her a lunch because I ruined her uniform and accidentally felt her up. Am I on a date?
Oh, wow. You really are a prize plank. I'm going to let you get on with it.
No, Ina, don't go. She'll eat me up alive. Girls, please don't have a domestic on my account. Tell you what, when you decide to ditch Miss Control Freak, come and let me up. Enjoy your spuds.
Are you sure you are?
So you had a gorgeous, funny nurse and you just let her walk away.
Will you just leave it? She was out of my league anyway.
Well, she will be if you continue hiding yourself away. I mean, before you know it, you're going to be some old maid surrounded by cats.
Do you really want to be a crazy cat lesbian?
Even the cats would turn you in the way if they had a date with me. I am that boring.
You've got enough stories for, like, the first 10 dates. And believe me, lesbians are all about the stories.
Since when did you become the expert?
Remind me to tell you one day. But first, I'm going to get you out of this rut, and more importantly, out of this minging cardigan. You are going to go round there and throw your lips on Kim.
Kim?
Kim.
Who are you visiting looking like that?
You, actually.
Come again.
I was a complete idiot today. I had no idea we were supposed to be on a date, otherwise I wouldn't have brought Grace.
Hang on, does she know you're here? I've heard stories about her and I don't want to lose my kneecaps.
We're just friends.
Well, whatever she is, I made a bad judgment call. I fancied you, you didn't fancy me. It's no biggie. I just know not to chat up the next girl that throws a cappuccino all over me.
No, I do fancy you. I think you're gorgeous. This is what I want. I want banter and fun and dates and snogging. I don't want hundreds of cats.
Cats?
Can we just pretend it never happened and start again? Please.
But you'd never ask. So, what was all that about snogging?
Nurse Butterfield!
If we get caught, then stop the kids so we won't get caught.
Oh, sorry!
Fraternising with her? She was fraternising with me. I mean, she's been stalking me for days.
I heard giggling. People being stalked don't tend to do a lot of giggling in my limited experience of stalking etiquette.
Dr. Savage, I'm the innocent party, I promise.
I won't report you this time. But don't let it happen again.
I won't. I've learnt my lesson. And I'll be avoiding Esther Bloom in the future. The girl just can't control herself. Look at him.
She made me sound like a crazy stalker. Me. Kim's done the chasing.
Also, she's just insecure. No, obviously she don't know what she wants. Right, I'll make it hard past. Time for your injection.
Come on, then. I won't come too close. I might not be able to control my massive obsession.
What was I supposed to say? Savage could have fired me. Can we talk about this outside?
We're kind of in the middle of something.
Please, just 5 minutes.
Go on. I can look after this for a bit.
It won't be long. It's really weird.
Grace, she's just helping me with business advice, that's all.
You got back just after you left.
Oh, well, nice of you to tell me. It's not like I've been walking halfway across the village.
Meet me at the loft later, yeah?
As long as you don't accuse me of stalking you. She's sorry. Really sorry.
How nice.
Ready for your injection?
Oh, I completely forgot.
Oh, just like you forgot to mention the surrogacy arrangement to Kim earlier.
I'm sorry, my brain's all over the place at the moment.
Esther, this is not good enough. These injections are really important.
Yes, I know, but the doctor did say we don't always have to do it at the same time.
Exactly, so let's just do it...
I have wasted a whole afternoon in your silly calf while you chased after some bird who blatantly would drop you like hot coal the minute something more interesting comes along.
Take that back. You were the one that told me to go after her.
I am not apologising.
Well, then maybe I'm not in the mood for an injection.
Look, of course, you've got to have your own life. Now, we fully support that 100%, don't we, Grace?
Of course.
Can I have a house white and 2 glasses, please?
You're meeting Esther, are you?
Yeah, Renee, it's kind of a date, if you're thinking of joining us again.
Of course she isn't. Have a good night.
Little tip. Esther ain't much of a drinker.
All right.
What's her liver? She had a transplant not so long ago. She's got to be careful. Well, especially at the moment, what with the baby and everything.
She got a kid?
No, not yet. But she will do. My kid.
OK, this is getting really weird. You sure you two aren't together?
Oh, I'm sorry. I just assumed she would have told you. Esther's going to be a surrogate for Trevor and me. She was probably just worried you'd run a mile.
Such an Esther thing to do. She's all right, isn't she?
Grace, can you give me a hand over here?
Look, I shouldn't be telling you this, but there's something else you need to know about Esther.
Bigger than a surrogate pregnancy, oh, don't tell me. She collects animal skulls, she's a Rebecca Black fan, and her name's not really Esther.
She tried to kill herself. Yeah, it's just, you know, we love that little girl so much, I don't want to see anyone push her over the edge again.
Was Kim here? She was supposed to meet me.
She left.
Did she say why?
Sorry, sweetheart. She must have had a better offer.